Welcome to the Glenn Beck program. We're glad you're here. Some of the other stuff that is going on today is really important, but we are trying to stay focused on what's right in front of us, and that is this debacle of the Biden administration in Afghanistan. I wish I could get on the ground at the airport of Kabul. I'd like to just see the faces of our troops. Because I'm imagining that they are not happy at all. And would just love to see them. You know, if somebody would just bring a camera and just pan, see what they are feeling.
I imagine they want to do a lot more than they're being allowed to do.
Oh, you got to believe it.
We have heard some reports over the past few hours that there have been some excursions into the city to pick up some people. Again, it seems like what we're doing is begging the Taliban to allow us to do these things. Reportedly today, the CIA director met with the Taliban to try to, I guess, negotiate.
Excuse me? Say that again. I think what I thought I heard you say was our CIA director met with the Taliban. So what did you really say?
What did I actually
say? Yeah, well, just now.
Say.
I misheard.
I'll just read this for you.
Mm-hmm.
CIA director secretly visited Taliban in Kabul.
Okay, a couple of problems with that. One, it's not a secret if we're reading about it.
Well, the meeting's over, apparently.
Yeah, again, not something you should broadcast. But I'm glad they did, because the other problem I have with that is, what is the CIA director doing meeting with the Taliban? Zay?
He's a former diplomat.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Met on Monday with Abdul Ghani Baradar.
Which, love that.
I got to say, the president's name was Ghani. Now we've got Ghani and the Taliban. I'm never going to be able to keep these people separate. I'm never going to know what anyone's talking about.
Change your names. I got news for you. I don't know who anybody is anyway.
I know. I want you to take a moment, Glenn, to bring yourself back in time a little bit.
Okay, yeah.
We started this show we started doing the talk show in like 98 or 99,
mm-hmm.
but the syndication deal we signed to go national, we signed in August of 2001.
One.
So mm-hmm. just weeks before the September 11 attacks.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then we were supposed to start the show in January 2002, but they moved it up because of the attack. So we've been basically on the air since September 11th, the arc of the show, a 20-year arc of the show.
Yeah.
Can you imagine, let's say, November 2001, I bring you back to that period, and I say, you know what's going to wind up happening is we're going to negotiate with the Taliban to basically give them the country. And then we're going to strand, and yes, Jen Psaki, I said strand, thousands of Americans and the Afghans who helped us in the 20-year war.
All right. Yeah. Wait. I got an
answer.
We're
going to have the CIA director go negotiate with the Taliban to hopefully move the Taliban's red line to the United States. If I were to give you that scenario, let's say November 2001, how do you feel about that?
Let me give you the scenario and my response. Mm. Let me give you the response I would have made in November. Stu, I know every empire has died in Afghanistan. I know that the British, the Soviet Union, there has never been anyone that has won a war in Afghanistan, but I believe in our troops, and I believe our troops will win the war. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
If you would have said to me, well, Glenn, yes, we're going to win the war, but then we're going to elect a president who's just going to abandon everything on the ground, including our billion-dollar embassy that we built because we won the war. And for 20 years, any girl under 20 knows the power that she has, the inherent rights that she has, but our president is just going to hand it back over to the thugs and killers that we killed and ran out 19 years ago. Then I would say, that's a fantasy. That's a fantasy. Mm. There's no way that could happen in America.
I have a terrible news.
Wait, I thought we were talking about just hypothetically.
Yeah, no, it really is incredible. I mean, I remember when the Obama administration first sort of pitched negotiating with the Taliban, and it's been a bad idea from president to president since day one. It's never been a good idea to negotiate with the Taliban, ever.
No.
And, you know, sure.
I was crazy angry with Donald Trump when he did it. I thought it was an embarrassment when he did it. But that's nothing compared to this. And anybody who thinks that Donald Trump would have allowed this to happen.
No way.
No way. Just let me just say this. Let's just say, and I don't believe this for a second. Let's just say he doesn't care about America at all.
Now, obviously, that's not true.
Yeah, it's not true. But Donald Trump is not going to allow Donald Trump to be humiliated, embarrassed that way.
No way. This is special. This is a special skill of Joe Biden. Taliban Joe, to be able to go down this road.
It really is.
Because he does not even seem to have the interest in protecting his own presidency.
No.
Let alone caring about the American troops, or let alone caring about the Afghans that helped us, or let alone caring about religious minorities there that are being murdered. Let alone forget all of that.
Forget all the women and girls that you say. I mean, guys, the left has absolutely no room to talk about the treatment of women and the treatment of girls and how we have to protect. They have no credibility. They have exposed themselves as not caring at all. At all. The people who should be screaming the loudest are the woke community.
Yeah, where's the Me Too and this? And not to mention, we've taken the Taliban from a bunch of people who basically were, you know, fighting in caves against us during the war, to one of the best and most well-armed militaries in the world.
Well, they're well-armed because we left everything behind.
75,898 vehicles, 599,690 weapons, 208 aircraft, reconnaissance equipment, 16,191. This is from openthebooks.com, by the way. Communications equipment, 162,643 items. Think about this, Glenn. We used to go back again to 2001 for a moment. What is one of the greatest advantages?
This doesn't work out. This doesn't work out for us.
What's one of the reasons why we do so well in warfare? When our military...
Because we have communications, we have night vision.
Night vision, right? Just take night vision for a moment. Tens of thousands of night vision goggles and associated equipment.
That, by the way, you...
You paid for.
And you cannot buy in stores.
You can't buy it.
You can't buy it.
You Americans, bought it, you just can't use it.
Yeah, Americans can't buy it for your use.
And so we gave that to the Afghan military, who then promptly turned it over to the Taliban here as this has developed. And now, if we, God forbid, if it gets out of control again and we have to go back in, which is totally possible, by the way, totally possible, if they again build an area that is a free passage for terrorists and they start blowing up our buildings, we're going to be back in there again. Don't dismiss this as if it's over, because that's the whole problem with leaving.
Don't count on Joe Biden to actually find a spine.
Well, it might be. Yeah, no, I'm not saying Joe Biden. It might be 10 years from now. But eventually we're going to go back in there and we're going to have to deal with a Taliban that has all this equipment.
Well, they'll have all that equipment anyway, because Joe Biden's son is allowing Chinese to come in and spy on our military and buy things, through bribery, et cetera, et cetera.
That's another huge part of this.
And China is going to give them all of that. I mean, did you see that China I think Saudi Arabia and Russia and Iran have just made a deal. China and Russia have also made a deal with the Taliban. I think there's an axis of evil that is being formed. And we strangely are trying to form our own apparent axis of evil. Where's the allied power here?
Don't copy their organizational structures. Can I also say, too, Glenn, we have this idea of arming other countries, and it doesn't always seem to work out the best possible way.
May I rephrase that a little bit? It never works out.
But can I at least, this is just an idea, and you know, can we float, because it's a safety tree.
Hey, safety tree. Can do it. I'm not going to cancel you.
A safe space.
Yeah.
Can we at least put self-destruct buttons in these things? I want a self-destruct. The Taliban takes over. We blow up all the weapons from one remote button. I want a drone that when they take off with a drone and they go to bomb somebody, it just flies back to the United States and lands safely. Why? I want a button that makes, I want it to just, you know how they have those like ink packets that when you steal money from a bank they explode. I want basically some version of that in every weapon we give to anybody else. So at some point when we decide they've gotten to the wrong hands, we just press the button and they all just go away.
I don't think that you've gone far enough.
No.
I would like the night vision goggles that if you steal it or, you know, we just leave it behind, you push a button and knives go through your eyes. That's what I would like. But maybe it's just me.